Hi everyone, I'm Travis Hinkle, Corporate Beverage Manager here at Del Frisco's and Advanced Sommelier. At the end of 2020, we debuted a really exciting new facet to our Wine by the Glass program, partnering with Distinguished Vineyards Wine Company and Free Flow to introduce some new wine on tap selections. Now, there's a few reasons why we chose to do this. First of all, it allows us to offer some really high quality wines at guaranteed freshness. It eliminates some of the waste that's usually inherent in Wine by the Glass programs in restaurants, and has some really exciting benefits for the environment as well. I'd like to introduce you to Ginevra Altomara. She's the Director of Trade Marketing at Distinguished Vineyards. She's a fellow advanced sommelier and WSET candidate. She's going to help sort of anticipate some of the questions you might have about wine on taps, as well as some of our guest questions and maybe even concerns. She'll then walk you through some of what we're currently offering and talk about Distinguished Vineyards. I'm sure you'll learn a lot. Ginevra, take it away.
Thanks, Travis. It's been great to partner with you and Del Frisco's over our long 20-year relationship. Distinguished Vineyards is a small-ish wine company with multiple brands over Napa, Sonoma, Oregon, and in the Southern Hemisphere. We are all about sustainability, and our vineyards and partners are certified both in wine growing and production. We are also all about equality. We are sponsors of the James Beard Foundation and champion their Equality in the Kitchen and Sustainable Food Culture platforms. Our company has a 50-50 split male-female leadership, and all three of the wines we will discuss today are made by female winemakers. Sustainability is at our core, and that is what started us on the journey to using kegs in some of our production. Free Flow Wines are a phenomenal company who help take the guesswork out of production, recycling, and storing of wines which have been kegged for a wines on tap system. All wines are kegged into stainless steel containers, the same material a lot of our wines are made in. Stainless steel will not impact flavor. The vessel keeps oxygen from seeping in using inert gas, so the open containers will last more than any open bottle of wine, so you can be assured your wines will not be spoiled the next day. This eliminates much of the waste that having a robust Wine by the Glass program can create. One keg is also the equivalent of 26 bottles of wine. This not only adds to the ease of making it through the night without having to open multiple bottles, but also keeps those bottles and cardboard boxes they come in from the landfill. Each keg gets recycled, sanitized, and re-kegged, so over its life, a keg can save over 2,000 pounds of waste from the landfill. That's one keg. And Free Flow uses 95% reclaimed water to purify, sanitize, and so their water footprint is very small. Kegs are also sterile and touchless. As you open, cork, and recork bottles, hands are coming in contact with the wine, the bottle, the pour spout. Tap handles do not come in contact with wine. So this is a much cleaner and sanitary execution. There are so many wines to choose from, and kegged wines come from all over the world. We at Distinguished Vineyards keg multiple wines from our portfolio, and I wanted to taste three of them with you today. First, we have the Markham Napa Valley Sauvignon Blanc. Markham Napa Valley was established in 1978, and we have over 200 acres of sustainably farmed vineyards in Napa Valley. Here's a map of Napa. The Sauvignon Blanc comes mainly from Oak Knoll AVA in the southern part. This is where the temperatures are more moderate, and this area excels in producing white wines, especially Sauvignon Blanc, as the cooler nights and longer growing seasons maintain the acidity in our Sauv Blanc. Napa is a Mediterranean climate with warm, dry summers and a winter-only rain pattern, a perfect climate for most wine grapes. Fruit from Oak Knoll tends towards a more sweet citrus and some tropical notes. When I taste this wine, I notice a lot of tangerine, maybe some lemon blossom, some pretty floral notes. The palate is dry and there's a little bit of nice bright acidity and a touch of tropical, like a little bit of lychee, a little bit of mango. So there's just this really beautiful rich fruit. It's mainly primary fruit. We use stainless steel for the fermentation. There's no new oak on this, so you won't notice any vanilla or toast. It's mainly all about that beautiful fruit coming from the southern part of Napa. The body is light to medium, so it would go well with lighter dishes. From the menu at Del Frisco's Grille, I would pair this wine with a shrimp cocktail to start, diver scallops, or the lemon dill salmon. Our next wine is McCrosty North Coast Chardonnay. McCrosty was established in Northern Sonoma and has an extensive vineyard partner program with some of the longest established farmers in the area. Some of our vineyards are farmed by families who have been working the land since the late 1800s. The North Coast is an interesting appellation. It's comprised of five separate regions: Mendocino, Lake County, Sonoma, Napa, and Solano counties. Some of these are growing regions that are coastal and cool, moderated by their proximity to the Pacific Ocean, as you can see here from the Sonoma coast and all the beautiful, windy, ocean-driven air that comes over. Some of the interior appellations are much warmer, and those produce wines with a fuller body and richness. As you can see from the Napa map, you have a mountain range that separates Napa from Sonoma. Lake County is located just above, so that's also more interior and can have warmer climate. For us, being able to blend the best of these areas allows us to create complexity in the wine. For the McCrosty Chard, we focus on vineyards in Sonoma, Mendocino, and Lake County. Mostly they are coastal, but some sites are a little bit warmer. Our winemaker, Heidi Breidenhagen, is a scientist and an artist. She works with dozens of fermentations to create the best blend and is very judicious with the amount of oak. Always French, and only a small amount of new goes into aging this Chardonnay. This kiss of oak is meant to complement the fruit, support it, and make it shine. We also maintain our natural acidity, so not very much malolactic fermentation. The wines are therefore much more food friendly, not overly creamy or buttery, but with a little bit of richness. We employ a small amount of batonnage, which stirs up the lees, releasing what's called mannoproteins into the liquid. This creates that fuller, richer mouthfeel. When I smell the aromas coming from the McCrosty Chardonnay, definitely get a heady aroma. Lots of tropical fruit, pineapple, but also really ripe yellow apple and pear. It's really very pretty and beautiful. It smells delicate almost, but when you taste it, you do notice a little bit of that oak. There's a touch of brown sugar, a little marshmallow, nothing really sweet because it is a dry wine, but it does have that sense of being rich. I find that it's a perfect complement to lobster bisque and broiled lobster tails, which you have on your menu, but also the roasted chicken with the chimichurri. The bite from the herbs and garlic in that kind of sauce would really intensify the fruit of the wine. Lastly, our Doe Rosé. Doe is an amazing project that we launched in 2020. It's the first partnership between a wine company, us, and the James Beard Foundation. We have been partners with the JBF for some years and feel that their mission of food sustainability and equality in the kitchen really resonates with who we are as a company. We launched Doe to support those initiatives, worked with chefs around the country to really dial in the wine profiles to ensure they are food friendly, and we continue to be a purpose-driven brand. The core responsibilities of Doe Wines are to make a moment or a meal enjoyable and to support and educate the community on the food culture and how together we can create a better system. Doe Rosé is made for keg only. We created this wine with Del Frisco's in mind. Rosé is a popular wine nowadays, and Doe creates ours from 100% Pinot Noir grapes. This delicate varietal has a thin skin, an aromatic nature, bright acidity, and some spice. We allow the juice and skins to be in contact for between 12 and 24 hours in order to extract a touch of pretty pink color and some texture, spice, and body from the flavonoids and tannins found in those skins. We source this wine from Oregon. Most of the grapes are coming from the Willamette Valley. Rosé is a great connector. It's a wine that can go from sitting on the porch to lunch to dinner. This version is dry, delicate, and fruit-driven. It can stand up to a lot of dishes from light meats and seafood to richer, fattier pork and charcuterie. It's traditionally Oregon, So what does that mean? Bright acidity, raspberry, strawberry, some rose petal. All the attributes that would come from a traditional Pinot Noir. Just a little bit lighter, a little bit brighter, more fruity. It's also awesome just sitting on the patio with some snacks for happy hour or before your meal. In looking at Del Frisco's menu, I think the Dough Rosé would be an amazing pairing with the ahi tacos, the salmon flatbread, and the Mediterranean shrimp. Any specials that showcase pork, pork chops or loin, or that contain bacon or prosciutto. And as a great connector, this can also be a new choice for a white wine drinker and allow them to enjoy their wine with a steak. Can we say that Dough Rosé is versatile? I hope you enjoyed learning more about these wines and Free Flow, and it will help you with your conversations at the table. We appreciate you and your partnership. Without you, I'd have to drink all this wine by myself. Please check out our website, dvwp.com, or join us on each winery's social media page. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks so much for listening, and have a great year.